What is up, y'all? My name is Nori, and welcome back to my channel. So, today we're gonna be doing a book haul. I feel like I haven't done these in such a long time, especially now that my library is not as good as the one where I used to live. So, I'm just doing everything digitally through Cloud Library or Kindle Unlimited. Or there's another program, I'll put it up here. But yeah, I haven't been buying as much books, which is fine because your girl really doesn't have space and your girl does not have the bookshelf for it. So these are the books that I have accumulated in the past month or so. Some of these that you've already seen because of my unboxing, but I want to show them here. So we're going to start with our manga first, and then we're going to go to the books that I bought, and then we're going to go to the rest of the stack of the books. So yeah, we're just going to jump right in. So the first manga is that we're going to be talking about, it is Something's Wrong With Us by Natsumi Ando, and I've heard some mixed reviews about this, but your girl is destined to try it out because it literally says a spine chilling steamy romance, which you love to see it. So it follows our main character Nao, and Nao and her family have always been part of the traditional Japanese sweets or candy making, but her only friend, which is Tsubaki over here, actually frames her mom for murder, and she rages revenge on him. So she decides to get closer to him, but you know things are gonna go wrong because even though that she wants his downfall, she's probably going to find a couple of things. It's gonna be very complex, it's gonna be maybe problematic, but sure as heck it's gonna be entertaining. I love to see it. I literally cannot wait to read this. The next story that we have here, it is My Androgynous Boyfriend Story in Art by Tamaku. And I'm gonna hold it up to the side because I know that the light's gonna reflect and it's gonna mess with the video and stuff. So this is a perfect Jose slice of life manga. I read the first volume, absolutely loved it, so I decided to buy volumes 1 and 2 so I could continue on with my collection. And this follows Meguru and Wako, and these two, everybody just doesn't seem, and they all have questions because Meguru, he is the cutest thing ever, and he's into fashion, and he's into makeup, he's into all the aesthetics. And then Wako, she is assistant editor, so everybody's always asking them questions, and she just doesn't see nothing wrong with it because, you know, they're partners, they've been partners for a very long time, since high school, and this follows them and their romance and the world around them. I loved it. I think it's so cute. I think Meguru is the cutest ever. And I think Wako, she is really cool too. So I love this series and I can't wait to continue on with it. Next volume that we have here, super excited. It is a Tokyo Ghoul Volume 1 by Sui Ishida. I love Tokyo Ghoul. I'm gonna hold it up to the side. I love Tokyo Ghoul. I have seen the seasons. I am still halfway through RE because I'm not really feeling it, but I love these characters enough to continue on with it. But Tokyo Ghoul anime, it is thebomb.com. So I had to pick up. Every time I went shopping, they never had volume 1. So I was like, shoot. I do love shopping online. I get books online all the time, but most of the time I do like to support bookstores because, you know, the online marketing, they already got a lot of money. So I'm trying to support small businesses and bookstores so that they can still be around. So they never had volume 1, and I'm just like, oh, I just want volume 1 so I can start my collection. And then one day I walk into the bookstore and they had volume 1. Ah, I'm so excited. So this follows Kaneki. And one day Kaneki was crushing on this girl in a little cafe shop, little nerd. He's a little cutie boy. And they start talking about this book and they go on a date. And it turns out that she is a ghoul and she attacks him, tries to kill him. But this freak accident happens where she gets killed, and they use her organs to save Kaneki's life. So Kaneki turns half ghoul, and it follows this world, his story, and everything else that happens. Oh my god, if you have not seen this anime, you need to watch it. And I'm super excited to pick up the manga. Again, I'm a huge fan. And if any of y'all want to buddy read this, let me know so we can start reading together. And the last manga that I have, it is The Promised Neverland Volume 4, story by Kayu Shida and art by Posuka Demizu. Oh my god, you guys know that I've been obsessed with this story. I'm obsessed, I'm invested, and I wish I had all the money in the world so I could keep reading this back to back. But if you did not know, manga is kind of expensive. For these little books, it's usually $9.99 or $12.99 or $15.99. So it takes a lot. Now, since this is Viz, I can read the stories in the app. So I think I'm going to start doing that and then collecting them as I go. But I need to pick this volume up because I need to continue on. And The Promised Neverland follows orphan children, and they are training up to the day where, you know, they get adopted. And well, that's not how things go here, and it gets very dark very quickly. The story is phenomenal, and for a person who does not like horror or thrillers, I'm invested. Like, I could not believe when I read the first volume, and then I just kept going. I was like, I need volume 2. And then I read volume 2 and I was like, oh my god, I need volume 3. I bought it. And I was like, oh, I need volume 4. So I bought it. I'm emotionally invested in this story. I want to see how this story comes out. And I want the safety of the children as well. So if you're reading this, let me know. And comment down your thoughts below so we can talk about it. The next stack of books that I have here, it is Barnes & Noble had a sale, and all of these books have the 50% off sticker. I couldn't help myself. I had to get these. One I did read. The other one, every time I see it, I want to grab it, so I had the chance to grab it. The other two, I need to catch up on the series. We're going to start with one, and I know this one is very problematic, so if you just want to skip for a minute where it's talking about a Stephanie Myers, with that, you will know. But I'm talking about Midnight Sun by Stephanie Meyer. I was a huge Twilight fan. I can recognize all the problematic things and harmful things that it has done to the indigenous people, so I don't want to promote this too much. But me and my best friend are reading this for nostalgic purposes, but we've kind of kept it to, well, I've kind of, but I've kept it to myself because I know a lot of people are not fond with it. So moving on. All right, next book that we have here, it is Today, Tonight, Tomorrow by Rachel Lynn Solomon. You guys know I love me some colorful books, and this looks great on my shelf. So this follows two teenagers, and I believe it's their last night, but their last night, it's going to be like a competition. But since these two have had like a high school rival for like the longest time, people are literally just want to take them down, and they actually have to team up together to survive their last night or their last competition in high school. I love YA contemporary. You guys know this. I love reviewing it. I love the nostalgic feelings that it, you know, takes me back. And it tends to be fast, it tends to be short, and it tends to be super fun and cute. So I cannot wait to pick this book up. The next book that we have here, it is The Black Flamingo by Dean Atta. I've already read this. This is a beautiful, beautiful book. And it follows Michael and his journey into discovering who he is, his sexuality, and his college life, which there he discovers drag. Oh my god. Again, I've already read the story. The story was beautiful, and it's filled with lines that pack punches. I adore this. I knew this is like the first book that I saw. I was like, oh, it's on sale. I need it. I grabbed it. I loved it. Amazing. If you have not read this, this is the perfect time to read this because you should be already reading POC or Black authors, Indigenous authors, all types of authors already. But if you did not know, it's Black History Month. Pick this up. And the last book that we're going to be talking about here, it is A Chain of Gold by Cassandra Clare. I saw this sticker right here. And if you did not know, I'm pretty sure this book is $30. It's $25. So it's not too bad. But $25 is $25 for this book. And I love Cassandra Clare. I've always been a fan of her writing ever since I was young, because she's been writing all of these books since I was a teenager. So I am actually behind. So if you can see, these are The Mortal Instruments and The Infernal Devices. I have read both of these, love them. So far, this is my favorite. Then we have the Dark Artifices series, which I haven't started yet. And then the second book to this one comes out this year. So your girls has to catch up to the last series, which is the Dark Artifices. And then I can start Chain of Gold, which it's everybody's favorite Cassandra Clare book, which totally understandable. Because first of all, this cover is gorgeous. Second of all, she's had so many years of writing that, like, I swear every year she just improves and improves with each series to come. So I'm super excited to be picking this up, but your girl has to finish that other series so I can pick this up. So this is the one that I have to catch up on. So I'm moving on to two books, and it is by the company Wattpad. Yes, you heard me right. It is Wattpad. The first one, it is Given by Nandi Taylor, and this follows a warrior princess named Yenny, and you know, she fights for her kingdom hard. She is very beloved, but her father falls ill, and she seeks to cure to again restore him. But she travels to this magical academy, and there she meets Weish, which he is a dragon shifter, and he says that she is his given, which is two people who are bound by destiny. So here she is, she's trying to find a cure for her father, she's trying to learn this impossible like magic. So there she is in a magical academy trying to train and learn this impossible magic, and then a dragon shifter says that, you know, they're bound together by destiny, so maybe he can help out to find the cure. And this is a Caribbean inspired fantasy with a magical school. We got dragons, we got black girl magic. It's gonna be a great time. I am dying to pick this book up. Honestly, this book is going to hopefully be read by February, because every time I look at it, I'm just like, oh my god, I need time to sit down and read this book, because it's just calling my name. It's dragons and it's magic and it has a school. You guys know that I love school settings, so your girl's gotta read it. And then the next one here, I've already talked about it, but I'll talk about it a little bit more. It is Revenge of the Sluts by Natalie Walton. And in the school, we have our main character. Eden, and she's actually one of the writers for the newspaper in her high school. But this anonymous person leaks out these girls' photos without any permission, without any consent, and the school is just too busy to do anything. They just want to take care of their reputation, and then everybody else doesn't think that these girls are innocent, so they all team up together to find this person and to bring justice. So a feminist badass story, we love to see it. The next story that we have here, it is The Ruthless Lady Guide to Wizardry by C.M. Wagner. And I've heard nothing but like really mixed reviews about it. So if you've read this, let me know down below. But this follows Deloria. And Deloria is just looking for a job when she comes to this post. And it's asking for all female crew bodyguards to protect this person. But you know, it's gonna go wrong. And we have like the found family trope, and we have a bunch of magical beings, and I'm pretty sure this has a sapphic romance too. So it's a great time. I can't wait to read it. Again, I saw on Goodreads and it had a lot of mixed reviews. So if you've read it, let me know in the comment sections down below. next two books here, we have the book of the month picks for, I believe it was January. I haven't gotten my February pick, but it's probably going to be Honey Girl. I'll put the picture up there. But yeah, the picks that I got was Dating Plan by Sarah Desai, which is two people. One is an engineer of some sorts, a software engineer, and the other guy, he's gonna get an inheritance, but only if he marries. So these two set up a fake dating arrangement for her side to get her parents and everybody off their back, and for him to get the inheritance. So they're playing off of each other. It's a fake dating trope. It's a beautiful cover. I can't wait. And the next one here, it is What Will Frida Do? A Guide to Living Boldly by Ariana Davis. I studied her when I was in elementary school, fell in love with her artwork, but didn't really go into details about her life. But now that I'm older, I definitely want to study her lifestyle because she is bold and unapologetic. So she's a badass female, and yeah, I can't wait to pick this up. And the last two books that I have here, it is two of my most anticipated releases of 2021, and I got them in book boxes. The bookish gods are on my side. The first one, it is Amari and the Knight Brothers by B.B. Alston. Oh my god, I am just obsessed with the cover of this book. The original cover is blue, and I got the purple one, but I technically want to buy the blue one too because it's gorgeous and like... hello, Black Girl Magic here. We love to see it. So this follows Amari, and everybody has told her to move on because her brother went missing and nobody's doing anything about it, but she has not given up until she finds a ticking briefcase in her brother's room, and this takes her off to a magical world where all sorts of creatures exist and there is a competition. So in hopes of finding her brother, she enlists in this competition. And here's the story. I'm so excited. This is middle grade, but that doesn't matter. Age should not matter in order for you to pick up a book. It's a beautiful book. It has a competition. It has magic. Like, what more else do you want? This is perfect. I'm going to be picking this up this month as well because, like, it's one of my most anticipated releases. I have to pick this up. And the last book that I have here, it is Lore by Alexandra Bakken. And this book, I love me some Greek mythology, but a lot of people are comparing it to Percy Jackson, which is a very beloved series on the internet. And let me tell you, I love anything Greek mythology or Norse mythology or any mythology I love. Okay, so your girl had to pick this up, but I didn't actually have to pick it up because it came in a book box. Boom. So in this world, there was a failed rebellion, and these gods, every some sort of like, I think it's like 9 years, they send these gods to live amongst humans, and then they make this competition of people hunting them down, and if you kill them, then I'm pretty sure you become a god or you take their power, something like that. And Lore's family got killed by this god, so she is seeking revenge, but she wants nothing to do with this world. So two people approach her, and she kind of gets sucked into this world again, but there are consequences to this action and things are not what they seem. So your girl is ready to be picking this book up. I'm so excited. This cover is beautiful. The original one is a white one, so it's an all white cover, but I still think it looks beautiful like this. Alright, y'all, and that is it for my book haul. If you have read any of these books, let me know. Even if you didn't like them, I still want to know so we can talk about it. And if you want to buddy read any of these books, the mangas, or the fantasies, or the contemporaries, or all of them, let me know in the comment sections down below so we can get together and start reading them. Again, thank you so much for your love and support. There's going to be some things going on my channel, so stay tuned. Your girl has a lot more manga content planned, and it's going to start with the graphic novels and the comics too. So we have a balance of literally everything on my channel. Everything bookish. I was thinking about doing maybe like a day where I don't do anything bookish, because I don't want to start a separate channel. One channel is literally enough. But that will be for the future. Thank you so much for stopping by. Show me some love by putting down purple hearts. But if you have nothing to say, just spam out whatever emojis that you use for this week. Thank you again, and I will see you next time. Bye.